Hey guys, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play, and today we are playing Cheese Cat-Astrophe, starring Speedy Gonzales. Do you see what they did there? Cat-Astrophe. That tickled me anyway. Let's have a look. Now, I had a little go of this before, and I was disappointed to find, despite the amazing animation, look at that animation there, barely anything going on, but it's so well done. And then when you actually select, look at that, how cool is that? I didn't get much further than this because it occurred to me there was no sound happening. I'm going to try this anyway in hopes that some sound happens. But as you can see, it's not... I'm not entirely sure. God, look at the animations. Amazing. Oh, no. Kidnapping. Yeah, and it makes a little noise and then no sound. Now, I don't know if that's a version problem or what, but there's no sound at all. So you're going to have to put it with the... sultry sound of my voice. I like the fact that we've got Bugs Bunny featuring, but of course I like the whole Warner thing. Now look how gorgeous this game looks. It's such a shame. Why has he got like 20 hats in his trousers? Anyway, it's such a shame that the sound's not going. I don't know what that's about, because I've tried other games since and it's fine. It's just this game. I wonder what the issue is with that. If anyone knows, answers on a postcard, or just tell me. Just tell me, we'll be fine. No, what are you doing? Oh, I see, you can build up a speedy run. Oh, I bet he does all the noises as well, and the underlay and all that. I'm out of hats, aren't I? I'm out of hats. Okay, can I jump on him? Yes, I can jump on him. But of course, this is a cartoon platformer. He's got like a red boxing glove. I want the boxing glove to be useful in some way. As in, grab that pepper, or whatever it is. There's a pepper, isn't it? Those spiders were a bit creepy. They actually gave me the spider creeps. What's going on with that Acme box? Oh, they are giving me the spider creeps. Oh, underlay, rebar, rebar. That spider is just coming at me. It's the way when you're on the ground, they come at you. They actually do come at you. When I leave the ground, they forget I existed, but... Oh, I don't like them. Oh, they are properly making me squirm. Scorpions I can live with, because, you know, they're kind of a staple. I just don't want to see any more of those spiders. Thank you very much. Now, I don't know why I have a problem with spiders. I don't really. I can deal with them. I used to have a big problem with spiders. And then my mum, when I was little... Me and my brother, in fact, used to have a massive problem with spiders. And then... When we were little, my mum took us to London Zoo when my dad was living in London. And I don't like the spiders. And that one's not too bad because he's just going left and right. It was when they spot you and come at you. It freaks me out. And my mum got us to hold a tarantula and my brother wouldn't do it. And for some reason, I often question how I managed it, but I found the nerve to go against my instincts and hold... a Mexican red-kneed bird-eating spider. That's how much of an impact that had on me. I remember its full name in full as I was told it. I can't get up there, but I'm sure I just got up one just as high before. Or maybe it's that. It is that. And I held this monster, and it was fine. It was an animal, you know, but. Something about spiders does have that effect on my, you know, primal instincts. Makes me uncomfortable. Get the baby Sylvester. Oh, I wouldn't mind, but I quite like cats. Well, you probably know that. I haven't heard several times that I've got three of them. And I think, yeah, it probably did help. I probably got over quite a lot of my fear of spiders that day because I saw that thing as an animal. Rather than a... Yeah. But since then, I kind of reverted. And in recent years, I was living with a guy who was absolutely petrified of spiders to the point where he was kind of quite cool until a spider would appear in the building. And he would literally squeal and wriggle and run and act ridiculous. And it was just pathetic, you know. I thought, nah, this isn't for me. And that was it. The turning point again for me was... He took a big programming book. Why can I jump on some and not others? That's a bit inconsistent. Also, I'm not sure I love the animation, but I'm not sure I like the way this plays. There's like a bit of There's inertia, but there's like weird delays to the starting of your movements. And I thought it was down to inertia, but I'm not sure it is. I think they're trying to simulate inertia by just adding a delay before you press the button. And it feels like that. Like the foreground moves with inertia, but the character doesn't feel like he does. I'm sure he does. I'm not sure he does. Anyway, and he just freaked out one day, took this big programming book, whacked it down on top of a spider and killed it. I remember thinking, that's unnecessary. Just because you're frightened doesn't mean it doesn't deserve to live. And I have a problem with cruelty to animals. I don't care what they are. I don't do cruelty to animals. I don't condone it in any way, shape or form. I certainly don't take part in it. So, he moved out eventually. Oh, did he? Yeah, you know he did, yeah. And then I was kind of, I had a spider situation come up. Where am I meant to go? Not down there, I've just been down there. I had a spider situation come up, massive spider in my living room. And I thought, you know what, I've got to deal with this. So I decided to cope. I'm not going to kill him, it's not going to happen. But to cope, there's one there. what I did was I had developed this technique, which was basically to have the kit on hand. I want to leave the level, the animation's gorgeous. To have the kit on hand to capture a spider effectively and to put it out in the garden. Now there are, oh you swans, there are rules to that obviously. The kit you need is basically, it's very simple. You need a plastic cup that you know you're never going to drink out of. One of those disposable ones will do. Or lots of those disposable ones. If you think you're going to see a lot of spiders, see that's annoying. They move at the same speed as you. Considering Speedy Gonzales, actually it does build up speed, I'll give him that. All those little eyes. Something very meagre about those eyes. Like a plastic cup and like a beer mat or something. Card and solid. You're no help. I don't know how I managed to get around him, but I did. Hey. You can pop on top of the cup. It's, you know, the old simple spider catching technique. And then, before you even start, though, they've got to be in a place. They've got to be in a place you can get to all the time. Hey, look, I'm invincible for some reason. Something's happened, and now I'm invincible. I'll take that. Before you can even start, you go and open a window. You have that ready, and then you go to your place where your beer mat and cup is, your spider catching kit, and then you deal with the spider. Now, I know there's a whole thing of being, why is this the same cave every time, or is it? It's not. It all makes sense now. Okay, yeah, we get it. On delay. Now, it seems that obvious, doesn't it? But preparation was key to me being able to cope with the spider. The only scary bit is getting so close to it. Oh, no, have I just killed myself? Oh, I was invincible a second ago. The only downside is that you've got to get close to the spider. And if you can't deal with that, you can't deal with that. But I made a decision to man up and deal with that. That was the thing. Right, so we're going down the halls to rescue the mice. Several conversations going on in my head at the same time. Right, so if you just can't deal with being within a meter of a spider, you've got a problem. But I made a decision to deal with that. And it's been effective so far. But those spiders still make me wig out a little bit, those ones there. Just because they look a bit real. I'm just running through this level now looking for the holes in the floor. Oh! That was a weird bug though, wasn't it? Where I just got invincibility for a moment with no cue to say I had invincibility. Oh, ow, can I throw hats? No, I've got no hats. Looks like I've just got to pop on the reds like that and hope for the best. Oh, it's a whole new world. Hang on, wrong IP. No, that's probably going to lead to the exit. Oh no, it's not. Cool. And those spikes, I thought they'd hit on the head, but they don't. Ow, they do hurt though. Weird that the sound's gone. I'm not happy about that. I was really hoping to... Oh, I jumped on his head. I'm not so sure. It looks nice. The animation's gorgeous. Everything else I can give or take. I can't tell you what it sounds like. But everything else I can give or take or leave. That's what I'm not give or take. What am I talking about? I love those little mountains in the background with the shadow down the side. You know, the dark half and the light half. Those little Speedy Gonzales style, Warner Brothers style touches, which are quite nice. Yeah, I like that. Anyway. Cheese Cat Cat-Astrophe minus sound, starring Speedy Gonzales on the Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.